Hello guys, so in this lecture we'll see next access control method, that is CSMA CD. This one is important as well. You can see almost every year there will be one question from CSMA CD. So this access control method is very, very important for gate point of view. So try to listen me correctly, guys. Here CS means what? Carrier sensing. What is carrier? Carrier means channel, nothing else. Means channel carries the data. That's why that is known as carrier. MA stands for multiple access. Multiple access, that means multiple stations are accessing the channel. That means multiple access means that is broadcast channel. And CD stands for collision detection. Collision detection. So let us consider, let's say this is one broadcast channel. Multiple stations are trying to access the channel. Let's say this is station A, this is station B. Isn't it? Now, what this access method says, that this access control method says, that any station can send the data at any time, but before sending the data, it sends the carrier. Isn't it? What does it mean? Carrier means channel, nothing else. Means we can say that, let's say station A wants to transmit the data to station B, isn't it? Let's say. Now, what will be A will do? A will sense this particular channel. So, you standing here at point A, if A wants to sense the channel, that means A will sense only the channel at the point of contact only. Entire channel cannot be sensed, isn't it? I hope this one is clear to everyone, because A is connected at the, we can say that, to the channel. So at the point of contact only A can sense the channel. Entire channel cannot be accessed by the A. Similarly, B can, yes, we can say that, sense the channel. That means at this particular point, B can sense the channel. Isn't it? At the point of contact. Isn't it? So, yes, first point you can write down. Any station can send data at any time, but one condition is there: before sending the data, it senses the carrier. Isn't it? It senses the carrier. And if carrier is free, then send the data. Otherwise, don't send the data. So you can write down next point. If carrier is free, what does it mean? That means no data is moving from that particular point of contact. That means carrier is free, isn't it? If some bits are moving at that particular point of contact, then we can say that, yes, carrier is busy. So if carrier is free, then send the data. Otherwise, don't send the data. Otherwise, don't send the data. I hope this one is clear to everyone. But remember, one possibility is there. Let's say these are the station A, station B. In between, various stations are there. Isn't it? So let's say A transmits, let's say A is sensing the channel. And let's say at that particular point, we can say that there is no data moving. Similarly, yes, B is also sensing the channel, and there is no moving bits or moving data at point of contact. So A can transmit, yes, A can transmit the data, isn't it? Similarly, B also can transmit the data, and you can see here there may be a collision. Collision of data means we can say that the data get corrupted, isn't it? Or while receiving that particular data, we will receive a garbage value, isn't it? So as soon as we can say that collision occurs, so this corrupted data, or we can say that these collision signals will move, isn't it, in backward directions, or we can say that these corrupted data will move, isn't it, and that will be received by B and A, isn't it? Now second point is, what we can say that how A and B knows that their own data get collided. Listen me correctly, guys, I'm repeating once again. How A and B knows that their own data get collided, or the collision signal received by A and B are the collision signals corresponding to their own data. How A and B get know, isn't it? Okay. So what is the procedure? Try to listen me correctly, isn't it? Because now A and B don't know that is the collision signal corresponding to their own data, isn't it? Because A and B will think that we transmitted our data and these collision signals are corresponding to the collision of some, we can say that other station's data, isn't it? So how A and B confirm that these collision signals are corresponding to their own data, isn't it? That is the task, and that is the collision detection. How A and B will detect this collision, isn't it? That is the point, isn't it? One more thing is there. Let's say acknowledgement scheme is there. Then once we can say that the acknowledgement, we can say that doesn't receive. Then we can say that if acknowledgement doesn't receive by the sender, then he can conclude that his data get collided or lost. But remember, CSMA CD doesn't support acknowledgements, isn't it? Isn't it? Various LAN technologies, you can see in LANs, these access control methods don't have acknowledgement scheme. So CSMA CD doesn't have any acknowledgement scheme. So yes, we can say that with the help of acknowledgement, there is no support, isn't it? So for second point or third point, you can write down CSMA CD does not support acknowledgements, isn't it? Now consider one scenario, try to listen me correctly. How, let's say this is A, this is B, isn't it? How A knows that their own data get collided? So listen me correctly, let's say this is the data that is transmitted by A, isn't it? So A is transmitting the data. Transmission means what? TT, isn't it? Transmission means putting the data over the link. That is the transmission. Is putting the data on the link, isn't it? Once completely data is placed on the link, then that particular data will be propagated, isn't it? Means the last bit come at the second end, then we can say that that particular data get propagated, isn't it? Similarly, you only tell me, if B is also transmitting the data, isn't it? A and B are still transmitting, isn't it? This much of data get transmitted, but this is the remaining data. That means A and B are the in the processing of transmission. Transmission means they are putting the data over the channel, isn't it? Putting the data means slowly bits will be moved and entire data will be placed. Then we can say that that data is transmitted. After transmission, there will be a propagation. Then entire communication will take place, isn't it? Okay. Now only tell me, listen me correctly. This is the point you have to pick this point. This is important one. Yes, A is transmitting, means the data size is large. And at this particular point, there is a collision. Now, listen me correctly. Now, collision signals will be received by A as well as B, isn't it? That means we can say that, yes, A and B are still transmitting And while transmitting, they received the collision signal, then they will understand that, yes, our own data get collided, isn't it? But once they transmitted the data, after transmission, data get propagated, and while propagation, there is a collision, then collision signal will reach to the station A and B, then A and B cannot conclude that these collision signals are corresponding to their own data. Isn't it? That is the point. So A and B are still transmitting, and while transmitting only, if collision happens, then collision signals will be received by A and B. While transmitting only, then A and B can conclude that their own data get collided. Isn't it? So from here, what you understand? Yes, you understand that data size must be large enough so that while transmitting only, yes, the station receives the collision signal, isn't it? Let us consider one more scenario. After that, everything will be clear to you guys, isn't it? Let me consider. Let's say next one. Let's say these are the station B and station A. And let's say the propagation time PT is equals to 1/2, isn't it? That means to propagate the data from one end to another end takes 1 hour, isn't it? Means last bit from A will reach at the station B after 1 hour. That is the scenario I'm considering. Let's say currently this is the time 10 a.m., isn't it? Let's say this is the time A, and at the 10 a.m., A and B, yes, senses the channel, and let's say channel is free. So both can transmit the data at the same point. Let's say A and B starts transmission, isn't it? That means A and B senses the channel. Let's say channel is free at that particular point. So A and B will immediately transmit their data. Now you only tell me at T equals to 10:30 a.m. what will happen? Yes, we can say that both the datas will reach at the halfway, isn't it? At the halfway, isn't it? At 10:30, after half an hour, we can say that the data will be on the half of the way. Now, yes, there will be a collision, isn't it? Now you only tell me. Now collision signals will propagate in the reverse direction, isn't it? So we can say that, yes, these collision signals will also take half an hour to reach at A and B, isn't it? So we can say that at 10:30 a.m. collision occurs, yes or no? And at T equals to, you only tell me 11 a.m., yes, we can say that A and B will see, the collision, or they will detect the collision, isn't it, at 10:30, isn't it? Okay. Now you only tell me, guys, at 10:30 they will see the collision, isn't it? They were transmitting, and while transmitting only, yes, they get the collision signals. While transmitting means they are trying to transmit the data only, isn't it? Okay. That means what we can say, that transmission time must be greater than propagation time, isn't it? From here we can conclude. Transmission time means the time required to transmit the data or to put the data over the channel. That must be greater than propagation time. That means 1 hour. Why? Because let us consider one more scenario. Let's say these are the station A and station B, isn't it? Let's say propagation time is 1 hour, isn't it? Now you only tell me at 10 a.m., let's say at 10 a.m., A started his transmission, isn't it? Let's say. And at, let's say, at 10:59 a.m., that means it is about to 11 a.m. We can say that just less than 11 a.m., isn't it? It is the time about 11 a.m. Let's say this data will be at this particular point. Let's say this is the bit, isn't it, of the data. it is about 11 a.m. Just before 11 a.m., if B senses the channel, then B will find that channel is free. Then B can also transmit. Let's say B starts the transmission, and exactly at 11 a.m., there will be a collision. That is the possibility, isn't it? Just before 11 a.m., B senses the channel and B finds that it is free. Then B will start the transmission. As soon as B starts the transmission, at that particular time only, that is 11 a.m., there will be a collision, isn't it? Okay. So we can say that at this particular time, B starts, isn't it? Now we can say that at 11 a.m., collision will occur, isn't it? Now collision will occur, then you only tell me these signals, collision signal will reach at A at 12 o'clock, isn't it? Isn't it? A will see collision signal. So we can say that at 12 a.m., yes, at the last point I have written at 12 a.m., isn't it, or 12 o'clock, A will see collision signal, isn't it? If it is not visible, you can see at the last line I have written that at 12 o'clock A will see the collision signal, isn't it? Because this collision signal will also take 1 hour to reach at the A, isn't it? That means what we can say that, yes, we can say that here, yes, that was the point A and B, station A and B, isn't it? So we can say that A is transmitting the data, isn't it? He is putting the data over the link, isn't it? Up to how much time? If we can say that if he transmitting for twice of PT time, isn't it? Then we can say that, yes, if we can say that A is transmitting over the time 2 PT, isn't it? And there is no collision signal received, then A will confirm that, yes, my data get received safely. There is no collision because of my data, isn't it? So here we can say that PT must be greater than equals to twice of PT. That means station A must transmit the data over the time 2 PT. That means he is putting the data for how much time? 2 PT time. If up to 2 PT time there is no collision signal received, then A will confirm that there is no collision because of my data. I hope this one is clear to everyone. Why this is greater than equals to 2 PT? Because 1 PT can take in the worst case, we can say that to transmit the data over the B, isn't it? Or we can say that after that, the collision signal will move in the backward direction. So PT plus PT, there will be 2 PT time, isn't it? So how TT will be greater than equals to 2 PT? So TT is what? Data size. Data size, that is L upon bandwidth. So yes, TT must be greater than equals to 2 PT. That means the data size must be large enough. That means A is still transmitting, yes, up to 2 PT time, isn't it? If he is transmitting up to 2 PT time, isn't it? And there is no collision signal received, then A will confirm there is no collision because of my data. If, yes, we can say that if A receives, we can say that collision signal before 2 PT, then we can say that A will confirm that there is a collision because of my own data. Because if collision occurs here, then collision signal will be received at the time less than 2 PT. If here, then we can say that then also at less than 2 PT. If at this particular, just before last end, if there is a collision, then there is a possibility that collision signal receives after 2 PT time. So A must transmit the data up to twice of PT time, means he is transmitting, means putting the data over the link, yes, for 2 PT time. That means the data size must be large enough, packet size must be large enough. so that he can transmit. But you can say that if data size is not so large enough, then what needs to be do? Then we can say that some extra padding of bits, zeros, can be added to the data so that data size becomes large, isn't it? I hope this one is clear to everyone. So TT greater than equals to PT, that is the condition for collision detection. That is important. Collision detection, isn't it? So here we can say that length of data upon bandwidth must be greater than equals to twice into PT. So L must be greater than equals to twice into PT into bandwidth. That is the condition, isn't it? And L is what? That is the size of the data or packet size. So whatever it is. So let us take one example. Let's say PT is given as 1 millisecond, bandwidth is given as 1 Mbps, and CSMACD access control method is used. Then question is, what is the minimum length of packet? Minimum length of packet to detect the collision in CSMACD. That means we can say that L must be greater than equals to twice of PT, that is 1 millisecond into bandwidth, that is 1 Mbps. Isn't it? So L must be greater than equals to 2 into 10 raised to power minus 3 seconds into 10 raised to power 6 bits per second. So these will be cancel outs and this will be remain in the bits only. So that will be greater than equals to 2000 bits, isn't it? That means data size must be at least equals to 2000 bits, isn't it? So that is the formula you can use in CSMACD. Sometimes it is also written as Ethernet. Be careful. Various times I have seen Ethernet, because Ethernet means CSMACD only, because in the Ethernet CSMACD is used, isn't it? So whenever Ethernet word is there, that means CSMACD, because in the Ethernet CSMACD is used, isn't it? Okay, so I hope this one is clear to everyone. So this formula is very, very important, isn't it? That is the minimum length of packet required, yes, to detect the collision, isn't it? Okay, otherwise if this much length or size of data is not there, then there is a possibility that collision may not be detected, isn't it? May not be detected, isn't it? So here you can see in this formula, yes, there is a propagation time, bandwidth, length. Yes, the three variables are there. Any two variables will be given and you need to find the remaining variables value, isn't it? That will be the question from CSMACD, nothing else. So almost every year you can see these type of questions, isn't it, from Ethernet CSMACD, and directly you can use this formula and you can find out the answer. Be careful, sometimes data will be given, some data is in the bytes, some in bits, so units must be same, isn't it? Be careful. Next one, yes, what will be the efficiency of Ethernet? Efficiency. So there is a derivation. No need to see that derivation. A long derivation is there for CSMACD in which some contention slots are included, isn't it? So for gate point of view, that is not required, isn't it? So efficiency of CSMACD or sometimes Ethernet will be given to you, because CSMACD is used in the Ethernet. So you can remember this one, efficiency of Ethernet is 1 upon 1 plus 6.44a. That is the efficiency in Ethernet or CSMACD, where A is propagation time divided by transmission time, isn't it? Okay. And you know propagation time is what? Distance upon velocity or speed, isn't it, of the cable. And transmission time is data size, that is L upon bandwidth, isn't it? So these parameters will be given to you in the question. You can find out the efficiency. Okay guys, so that's all about CSMACD. So next topic we'll see in the next lecture. Okay, guys, thank you so much.